Before the video starts, I just wanted to say that these hoodies, there's only 2 days left to order it, but I'll have a link in the description. This is a size large, pretty small fitting, I think. I'd probably want this bigger, a bit bigger. So I ordered a double XL in the white one. That's it, enjoy the video. I wanted to film a little paint with me because I'm feeling very relaxed today, and I find it really therapeutic to talk to a camera too, because I can't see a therapist at the moment because my family are on lockdown. So I thought I'd just talk about myself a bit. It's the one time a week I can be a bit self-indulgent, and I don't think I've actually just talked alone to the camera in a while either. I earned it basically. And also I found it much more beneficial to be a bit more self-indulgent as long as you're improving yourself or on a path to personal growth, because it affects your relationships that you have with the people around you and it helps you be a better person, I think. Put things into perspective and be a lot more introspective. I'm talking shite now. I got 2 tattoos off Emer a few days ago. I'll insert a video. And this one, it's still a bit fucked. Anyway, but she's always given me tattoos and shit, so I thought I'd paint her something as a gift. I'm not the best artist at all, but it is therapeutic and it's something nice to give her that is like made by me. I have a rough idea of what I want to paint. So I was thinking a lot about some comments that I got over the last while, especially on my birthday vlog, because everyone was saying this is the best video. I'll insert the comments now, like this is not me talking shite. A lot of people were like, this is the best video you've uploaded, it's so nice to see you come into the person that you are. And I kind of agree, because I feel like I'm a lot more natural when I'm in videos with my friends and family, because that's actually how I act, I suppose. When I'm just on my own in front of the camera, my subconscious mind is like, be entertaining or no one cares. So I suppose it is still me, but it's just more amplified, I guess. Or maybe it's the opposite way around. Maybe I'm more entertaining when I'm with my friends and family. I have absolutely no idea. I feel like I think I'm self-aware when I'm actually not. And I know a lot of people in my life that I've met over the last while who think they're really self-aware are most likely the least self-aware. Especially if they keep saying it to people, like, oh, I'm so self-aware. They're usually not at all. I'm conscious of that, but I would like to be more self-aware, so I suppose that's why I make these videos. And because, yeah, it entertains me. I don't know if anyone actually enjoys them, but I like talking to a camera because it does kind of put stuff into perspective, especially when I'm editing over it, because I get to see what my running commentary is. You forget your thoughts sometimes, but if you're recording yourself while it's happening and then editing it over, you realize what your natural train of thought is like. Yeah, I feel like I don't have an actual realistic grasp of who I am. I don't have a realistic grasp, at least, of how people perceive me, because most of the time I just assume that people that I don't know hate me or think that I'm annoying because I do YouTube videos. And especially with trying to find, I'm not really on the hunt for a romantic partner, but I've been seeing people, and even if they're romantically interested in me, I just expect them to get the ick. And I suppose that's a result of my last relationship, or insecurities that I feel from how my last relationship ended. I just think that people are going to turn on me and all of a sudden not like me, because I do think breakups are like the most valuable learning experience that a person can have, because you learn a lot about yourself and how you treat other people. Because at the start, obviously, I was wallowing a lot and thinking, oh, poor me, which is like obviously so allowed. If you're going through a breakup, like, you're so allowed to wallow. But I also did realize only in the last 2 months, like, my breakup, Jesus, Keelin, shut up, get over it. I'm like, my breakup only happened 7 months ago, but I feel like it was actually the renaissance of my life. That's what Saoirse's boyfriend Paul was calling it. He said that it would be the renaissance of my life, and I was just like, obviously very upset at the time, like, shut the fuck up, Paul, you don't know what you're talking about, you're 18. He is wise beyond his years, but he was completely correct, because I feel like I am a completely different person, and I've learned so much from it about who I am and how I treat other people and how other people deserve to be treated as well. And that's not a direct result of how he treated me, it's also how I treated him, do you know what I mean? Because in the last two months, I haven't been like out partying as much. I've been kind of at home having time to think and writing in my journal. I'm kind of doing shadow work, if anyone's ever heard of that. You kind of address the dark side of you, or everything that's wrong with you. It could be, you know, your ego, if you're a bit selfish sometimes, which I can be, definitely. And what I found from my last relationship is that I was so caught up in how I was feeling, I kind of probably didn't like check up on him enough. Now, the relationship wouldn't have worked out regardless of if I changed my behavior or not, but this is just stuff that I learned from how I could have been better in the relationship. I definitely wasn't financially secure enough, even though I was a lot more depressed when I lived in Galway. I didn't really have any of my own friends, so I was depending on him a lot for my socializing or social fix or whatever. So that is putting a lot of pressure on the other person. I probably wouldn't like if someone else was doing that to me. And now I have my own friends in Galway, which is weird because I don't live there anymore, and I actually made more friends not living there than I did when I did live there. I think it was because I was so dependent on him, I didn't really put myself out there a lot. It's much easier to make friends when you're single, I think, anyway, because you're like saying yes to more things and more opportunities, and I don't know, making more of an effort to talk to people or get to know them. I don't really know, because I'd be more inclined if I'm in a relationship to like stay in every night and just chill out with them, do you know? Back to what I was saying. I have no idea of how people perceive me, because like the last few people I've been seeing, I just expect them to start hating me, and obviously that's just gonna put a fucking wedge in the relationship and it's not gonna progress anywhere. And I always think that like their friends slag me behind my back, and if I meet their friends, like they're gonna already have a preconceived idea of who they think I am, or that I'm like an annoying attention seeker sort of buzz, you know? Like, don't get me wrong, I love attention, obviously. But you know, a 10-minute snippet of me on YouTube is not what I'm like 24/7 either. And I think I proved that more with like my more recent videos. And another thing is, from like people I've been seeing and all, I benefited a lot because I'm learning a lot about myself, obviously. But I'm also making loads of new friends from it. And like friends with people, oh Jesus, I gotta say, friends with the people I have been seeing, but also making friends with their friends. I love meeting new people. Like, I absolutely fucking, like, it's actually brought me purpose in life. And I think my philosophical meaning of life is to meet new people and see what you can give them as a gift. You know what I mean? Like, if you can make them feel a bit happier or better about themselves, I think that is the fucking, the best gift you can give someone, is to have an impact on people that you meet. That's kind of what I've been doing, and I've been making loads of new friends from it. I kind of, I'm on that buzz where I think maybe all the people that I'm meeting has been fate, especially with Emer, who I'm making the painting for now, who I am 100% in love with, obviously. I wouldn't be making her painting if I wasn't. We have so much in common, and I think we just improved each other's lives in so many ways after meeting each other. And we met through someone I was seeing, and like that didn't work out well at all, but the gift that I got from it was Emer. So I don't think anything, and especially after a breakup, you can be like, oh, that was such a waste of my time. But you have to look at all the things that you actually got from it. Like, I got amazing experiences, I met so many fucking class people, and it's been phenomenal, to be honest. I'm probably the most content right now than I've ever been in my whole life. Like, obviously there's some obstacles that I'll have to go through soon and work on myself a bit more, because I don't fully think that I'm 100% a good person yet. You know, I'm on the path to being a good person, or what I perceive as a good person. But at the moment, you know, I'm still doing, you know, fucking normal human shit, like bitching about people and all. It's also kind of hard when I've realized from meeting new people is some people actually do have ulterior motives and are toxic. Because I'd be a bit more naive now. Last year, I'd kind of just trust anyone and think they're good people. Meeting people now, there are some fucked up people who just are out to use others. Now, I don't know if they do it subconsciously or consciously, but what I've had to do is just be absolutely civil with them. I'm not mean to anyone, but I really have to distance myself. Now, sometimes that does mean like sacrificing a night out or something, but like, fuck that. Like, night outs are all the same anyway. But I've been doing that recently where I just like go home, and I don't want to exclude anyone. I'm not gonna be like, they're not invited because they're toxic. Do you know what I mean? But I can just take myself out of the situation instead, because it's for my own mental health and well-being, because people like that just bring your energy down or something. I don't know. Now, it wouldn't happen to me a lot at all, but I think a lot of times, like, I hate excluding people and all that shit. So I love the circle that I'm in at the moment. Like, my fucking, it's phenomenal, the amount of friends that I have, and they're all fucking fantastic. I'm cursing a lot. They're all fantastic. They brought so much light into my life. So I don't really need to be hanging around with people that are bringing me down. I suppose just I'm making myself more aware of the signs of like toxic people. Like, people, for example, who would base their relationships or friendships off bitching about others or having a mutual enemy. You know, a lot of people after my breakup as well would try to relate to me by like bitching about my ex or something when I wouldn't be in that mind frame, or like just didn't want to talk about them. I think people like that, you just have to steer clear of. Like, obviously at the start I was a bit more down in the dumps, so I'd probably perpetuate that behavior or feed into it. But now I'm just not arsed anymore. I just want to talk about nice things. Okay, that's such a nice color, isn't it? I'll give you an idea of the picture I want to draw. There's a picture of me and Emer kissing. I want to kind of like that, and then a little poem for at the end. I've also found myself being in love with a lot of people. Like, I have a friend who I've known for years, and he definitely knows that I'm in love with him. Like, I give him presents all the time and all. I'm comfortable never wanting to be in a relationship with him. I think you're allowed to be in love with people and not want a relationship, which is so nice. It's such a nice feeling for some reason, because there's no pressure, and you know that your heart's never going to be broken, because I'm comfortable just being in love with the person but not wanting anything in return. Is that fucked? Probably. I'm gonna wait for this to dry and have a smoke and come back. Also, my throat is fucked. It's because I'm chain smoking and reading and learning tarot, because my family has gone into self-induced lockdown. I don't know by the time this is uploaded, if the country will be in level 5, but my family have decided to go into lockdown. I literally haven't seen my sisters in 3 days, and I'm having withdrawal symptoms. It's really making me sad. And every time I see serious stories, I start crying. My emotions are very heightened, but I love feeling emotional rather than the numb. As well, if I've been talking to any guys or anything, I just feel like a piece of shit talking about my career, but I never define myself by my career, or I don't define other people by their careers either. I was at a party with like all this guy I was kind of talking to, was
friends, and all of them would have been musicians, and one of them just kept calling me YouTube, didn't know my name, and was just calling me YouTube. I'm friends with him now, he's actually sound, but he just kept calling me YouTube, and I was just like, oh my god, I'm an embarrassment, it's humiliating, and everyone's taking the piss out of me, do you know? Like, I did this as a hobby, and I find it really fun, therapeutic, and I know that it brings light into other people's days, watching my videos. I'm not saying that as an ego thing, I actually get comments confirming that, so I actually make people happy. I actually get comments saying that, which I find hard to believe as well. It's actually like the nicest compliment anyone can ever give you if you have an emotive response from someone. But so I keep doing this, but it's just by chance that it's actually my job, which is so handy because I find it's like literally the easiest way to make money. And I suppose I wanted to break in whatever the fuck this stupid world is like, because I don't ever want to work for someone else, and this is like the easiest way ever to do it. And I don't like vilifying leisure time, like I don't think this is like selfish or anything. I've tried to train my mind into not feeling bad about this being my job and me chilling all the time. Like, I'm just straight up chilling and spending time with my friends, and like that's the life that everyone wants to work towards, isn't it? And then I just feel guilty for doing it because I feel like I should be doing more or have like a more noble career, even though I'm trying my best to be a better person and impact on the world, I suppose. But what I'm doing, I think, is making enough difference for me to not feel guilty about doing it. This whole video is just gonna be me contradicting myself. Anyway, I'm gonna have a smoke now while this dries. Okay, back. Yeah, what was I gonna say? Yeah, I'm kind of excited for a second lockdown because I kind of want to do loads of shit. Well, I did loads of stuff the last time, but I was like busy being heartbroken, do you know what I mean? So I was like working on myself, trying to build up my self-esteem again. But this time, like, there's so many things that I want to do. Okay, I'm gonna need to concentrate now to draw this, but... I'm low battery. Bollocks. Okay, I just did the font there, and I think I'm gonna have to time-lapse me colouring this in because I really can't talk and do it at the same time. These paints remind me of, you know that episode of Barney where they have all the colour, the different colour paints? Does anyone know that episode? And I always wanted, as a toddler, I always wanted to eat it. So problematic. Still kind of do, to be honest. Oh god, I always start things and then can never finish them. Kind of got halfway through the painting, but I don't like the arm, so I rolled over with more pink, so I don't know how I'm gonna finish it yet. I don't know what to do, but I'm not liking it at the moment, so I'm gonna wait until I have more ideas to actually finish it. But I started painting these little faces that I'm into, and I painted a few other things that I'll go into in a second too. Oh fuck, I ripped that one. I painted this one for my friend Courtney. Trauma bonded. Trauma bonding is if you were in a relationship with a narcissist, it's called trauma bonded. That's her buzz anyway. And then I did this one for Saoirse, because everyone always asks about the scar on her face, which is actually a birthmark. So it says it's a birthmark on it. So I'm gonna paint two more of these, one for my friend Kev and one for my friend Evan, who I'm sending a letter to, and I'm sending Kev a top. I'll give them these little paintings with them. I also recently, it's been like 2 days, so since I first recorded it, Ireland has gone into a level 5 lockdown, which I was expecting anyway already, so it wasn't really a shock to me. I've also gotten a room in London, in East London, so fuck yeah, baby. Big things coming soon. Yeah, it's getting real sentimental up in here already with my friends and shit. Yeah. Yeah, the waterworks haven't set in yet, but I'm expecting them to, big time. Because obviously being in a lockdown, I can't actually see my friends. Like, I kind of was hinting towards I wanted a surprise party for going away. Obviously that can't happen anymore, but I'm not too upset about it. But anyway, I'm moving in 10 days, so I'm moving amidst the lockdown, like literally in the middle of it. So hopefully I can still do shit in London. Obviously I'll be quarantining for 2 weeks when I arrive, so I'll be probably just making loads of YouTube videos anyway, so you'll see what the story is there. Fucking fair fucks to the frontline workers, anyone who's actually still working. I can't believe that. Oh, this, did I show this one? This is the one I did for me. I can't believe that Brent Thomas is staying open. Pretty fucked up, but structuralism. I'm buzzing for this one because in the first lockdown, I found out so much about myself and who I wanted to be and how I was embarrassed of who I was. And even I'm still getting those, like a secondhand cringe, you know, like a secondhand cringe, but actually for myself. Fully cannot believe that, Cora's screaming outside. I fully cannot believe that I actually had a boyfriend last year, because I was looking at my old TikToks. If you knew me last year, no you didn't, because I'm so disgustingly embarrassed of who I was. I feel like I've actually aged 5 years in the last 7 months. But anyway, we're over it. It's all about growth. It's a growth journey, baby. And I probably will still get it. Like, I say I'm gonna look back at myself now in another 6 months and be like, who the fuck does she think she is? I just didn't know who I was or what I wanted to be, or I didn't know anything about myself. So yeah, I'm kind of buzzing for the second lockdown, even though I won't get the full experience of it because I will be moving in the middle of it anyway. So I won't like fully be in a lockdown, if you get me. Like, I'm only really in lockdown for 10 days and then I'm actually moving country. And then I get to live with my friend. So like, I won't be on a like road to self-discovery. But yeah, I'm so excited to make new friends and meet new people. They have to drive. Yeah, so over the past few days when I haven't been recording, I painted a few things. So another thing I realized is I'm actually a fucking weird, like I'm a freak, but like I don't mean I'm a fucking freak in the sheets. She's a freak. She's so quirky. I mean, I'm actually terrifying. Like, I'm actually scary because I need to tell the story. You know, if you have internalized shame, you need to tell other people so you don't feel as bad. I'm getting that right now. So I'm going to have to tell the story. I saw a picture of this guy on my friend's story. Never met the guy before. Don't know who he is. So anyway, I was like, he's kind of cool. I want to paint him. So I just painted him. And don't get me wrong, the painting is really good. Then I put it on my close friend's story and I was like, who is this man? Turns out I actually do know him. His girlfriend follows me on Instagram. His girlfriend follows me on Instagram. So I'm just gonna have to burn it or something so no one ever finds out, or like especially him or the girlfriend ever finds out that I painted him, because that's so weird. And I put up a poll on my close friends being like, what if I got this, because he lives in London. And what I was like, oh no, is that too much information? I was like, what if I brought this painting with me to London, had it hanging up in my room, and then for some reason, like, he was in my house for a party or something and saw it. And I put up a poll being like, is this creepy or romantic? And everyone was like, Keelin, that's so creepy. I'm just so intense. And then so I was reflecting on my past brief flings over the summer. One of them, I knew the guy for a week, and I had read him a poem that I wrote him. Don't get me wrong, he was into it. That didn't work out because I ended up not being into it, but like, I fully wrote him a poem after a week of knowing him. And then another guy I was like, had a crush on, like not even seeing him, barely even went on a date. I sent him a book to his house that I thought he might like posted it to his home address, like where he lives. So yeah, getting real creepy. The other thing I painted up, I really have to keep to myself because it's like so embarrassing with who I painted it up. Yeah, I must be having a meltdown, but I'm not really at the same time. It's a chill meltdown, like I'm kind of into it. I'd say me being this intense is so dependent on if the other person is into it or not, because it can come across as kind of a notebook way. Why isn't focusing? Like romantic in a notebook way, or it could be like creepy in a cut off my ear, sending it to you in the post way. It's absolutely fine. Do you know what? It's developing my character. And another thing, yeah, remember at the start of the video I was talking about how I'm embarrassed of doing YouTube and it's like an embarrassing career choice. And if you meet someone at a party and they're like, oh, I'm a director fucking, or an artist or whatever, they're all very admirable careers to have, really creative. Like, I prefer if someone was nice to me than a fucking musician, you know? But anyway, so when I go to parties I'm like, oh, I'm a YouTuber, like I'm embarrassed to say it. But I think the reason why when I do things or like make anything I have this like urgent need to show people, or like need for approval or external validation, is because you know that your inherent core values or characteristics are developed from the ages of 0 to 7. And from the ages of 0 to 7, I had gotten new to younger siblings, so I probably didn't get as much attention as I'm really bullshit now. I'm really analyzing myself. I've been in lockdown for 3 days and I'm like, I'm actually a psychologist now. Because when I was developing from the ages of 0 to 7, I got 2 new siblings. I probably wasn't getting as much as attention as I was before then. So now as an adult, I'm still like, I need mummy and daddy's approval. So that's why I do YouTube, and like if I make any art I have to like put it on the internet for people to give me compliments. I haven't lived with my mom for about 5 years, and I still, if I do something, I have to tell her straight away. I'm like, mommy, look what I did, mommy. Like, it's so embarrassing, but at the same time I just love it. This is so therapeutic to me. Like, I'm putting everything into perspective here. But yeah, since I'm trying to fill up the boredom with a lockdown, I'm mad into like journaling and scripting and all that stuff. But anyway, what I've been doing is, because I'm so comfortable with being on my own at the moment, like really working on myself and like trying to figure out if I actually like myself, and if I don't, what can I change, and what can I do to distract myself from going on my phone and looking for external validation all the time. What I've started doing is writing out my ideal person if I was going to get into a relationship, because I'm not accepting anything less than worshipping the ground that I walk on, because I think everyone deserves that. Anyway, so will I read it out? Is that really embarrassing? Let's see what I have. I also haven't changed out of my pajamas in 3 days, but sure, look, you can't smell me through the camera. But I feel like my ideal person who I'd want to be in a relationship is just like taking characteristics from all of my best friends. From Reese, I'd want his protective nature, so protective of me, so loyal, take on the world for me. Then from Aisling, I want her caring, mothering, nature, nurturing sort of vibes. Emer, fun. Josh, St. Ledger, sense of humor. Ruth, supportive in any sort of aspect of your like career or any projects that you want to start. She'd be so like, yeah, fucking go for it. Okay, the first character. characteristic I have down is single. They need to be single. Oh yeah, likes Jeff Buckley and Paul Simon and all. Like, I just need, because I've been with people who have no, like, don't have, like, complete opposite taste in music in me, and it's actually just mentally draining and it's not worth the time. I just don't think so anymore. I think as I'm maturing as an adult, I want someone who will listen to the same music as me, and I won't be embarrassed with sharing songs, because one of the most romantic things you can do for a person is send them a song and say, this reminds me of you. Isn't that lovely? It's a lovely thing to do. So I'd love if someone did that for me, or I was able to do that for someone, and they wouldn't be like, this is a shit song, you know? Oh yeah, next one is interpersonal growth, into psychology, that sort of thing. Next is in touch with their emotions. I want a crier. I want someone who can cry. Kind, funny, friendly, around 25. Because I was thinking, I like to see myself as very emotionally mature. I think I am. I think I'm very wise. I'm good at giving advice to people. But I'm also, as we've seen in, you know, 5 minutes before, previous to this video, I can be a bit intense. I'm assuming that stems from emotional immaturity. Probably someone who's around 25 years old is like the perfect medium for me, where they're not too mature for me and they haven't reached the bitterness of the 30s yet. See, someone my own age is just too immature. I'm being too picky, probably. I have another one down. Likes coffee. Enjoys the odd rolly, but doesn't have to be a smoker. Is into mushrooms. Also not essential, but I did say in another video, you'll only get, this is not me being like, they have to fucking like drugs. In my previous video, I did say in my dating advice video, I did say that my ideal date is in a bath with shrooms and a bottle of champagne. I did get a bottle of Moët off my friend. So now I just need someone who actually would do that with me. So that's why I have that down. Next we have, laughs at my jokes. That is essential. Next one, makes me comfortable. Pretty obvious, but next, supportive. Next one, likes holding hands. Also essential. I do have clammy hands. Like, they are clammy, but they have to hold my hand and not care. Like, my hands are always dry unless I'm holding someone's hand that I like, because then I just get nervous. Next one, self-aware, but doesn't have to be too self-aware. Next one, impulsive. You know, I could have written down spontaneous, but I'm writing down impulsive because, you know, I'll accept some negative connotations with the person. Otherwise, it's just unrealistic. I myself am very impulsive. I'll make impulsive decisions. So I need someone who can balance me out and kind of do it with me. Next one, likes the planet. Next, ambitious, caring. Next one, fun. Next one, a good friend. Last one, believes in tarot. Maybe at the start they can be a bit skeptical, that's fine, but I can get them into it and I can read their tarot cards all the time. Anyway, yeah, that's my ideal person. So if you see me with a boyfriend in the next 6 to 12 months, just assume that they have all those characteristics, because if they don't, I'm not accepting it. No, might not be able to see what I'm doing here. I can't remember how many hoops he has. Kevin, how many earrings you have? Kev doesn't smoke, so just give him teeth instead of a smoke in his mouth. Hello! Come here! Do you want to say hello?
Hi!
Made his forehead too big, he doesn't have a big forehead. That's it now. Blue boy! He doesn't watch my videos, so he won't see. Or does he? I actually never know. I just assume that no one watches them. And then I regret, like, oversharing so much. I'm so embarrassed of when I went to my... I shared so much through my breakup. Like, all the poems and all on my Instagram. It's so embarrassing. Like, who actually let me away with that? In fairness, like, I learned from it. But, like, what the fuck was I thinking? So tragic. That's it now. That's the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. Bye.